Vatura and Zara, Tafan and Zara, no Pangatira Mira, Vana, when I was going to my man, Vacha, Fran, Vadama, Fizz, now and a coop. Then you would be what may want a coop, Sangatno Jay, two day. Toy Jay, and a Matai, so Tora Ramasay, Tora Ramasay, Tarwazi was Jesus, I take it. Jirema, Chirikazi, Nere, Tora Ramanes, Satora Ramasay, Toshira Ramasay, two day. But this is Namara Mira, Angola and Zara, Gaga, Kwango, Fanane, Kufa, Taura, you and Okufa Quacho.
But it's gonna cause the stampede in Zimbabwe. People who are living within Zimbabwe, how are they going to live? Muri, because Zimbabwe, Muri, work for a month, not a bad rent, and then you demolish my industry. So what are people gonna do next? How are we going to earn our living? I would even want to ask the president if you are looking at the situation going around in Nikameni, Munutizoni, Wakakupai vote, how are we going to live? Pandadun, go Pandruku Poneron, go Pandruanasi, Chekuji, Gakana, Uram Samuang, go Pamus, come Kinipuany, in this Nagana Govenda can have windows, but Sakandunus Ura Mane. Are you promoting thug ship? Are you promoting people to kill each other? What are you trying to show us, right, as citizens of Zimbabwe? Last year we had to vote for you, we gave you our vote, and then my office, my good demolish, as we said. So how are we going to live?
Plan B from day one, yeah, but so far things are not settled. Respect. Zimbabweans, yeah, living under very difficult situations. Very difficult situations we are living. We've been robbed our life by COVID-19. Now we are having a mafia government. Like, if you look at countries like Syria, Somalia, Central Republic of Africa, this is the kind of things we are going, because we don't have any good administration in this country. If you have got a government which is sympathetic to the people, could have seen an alternative at least. Because you can't destroy the people's livelihood without an option. How are they going to do now? What are they going to do? People want to live. People have already been in intensive care for a long time. Since COVID has started. No industry, no what. Look at such a kind of administration we are looking at. We don't want this kind of system. It's only because people, they've found people already in intensive care. Because people have already been robbed of their life because of COVID. Now they cannot do anything. No power, no what. They cannot react to such a situation, but they are paid, it's painful to them, if I can tell you. But now, what is going to happen is it's a matter of time. Time has got its own. Because people are now going to react as we speak. Because suppose if you leave all these people in Harare, all in cities, without what? Without an option, what are they going to do? Look at this. Their houses are being broken into without any solution. Those people are looking for a livelihood. But this is only left to the authorities. It is because of the authorities which are mismanaging the resources. If you can look at what COVID-19 has done, it is only 2 years ago. But what is happening is like nobody has been assisted. They've spoken about food, this and that, but you can't even get it. Even a mask to protect one another, you can't even get it, but they are being sold. It's something like dollar US. What does that mean? A dollar can make a family survive, a family of five. But we don't want this kind of system. We need a revision of our system of governance. Because what we are witnessing now is what is happening. If you go to the Central Republic, if you go to Somalia, you go to countries like that, the people will now get to a time when they'll say enough is enough. Yes. They will rise up to their youth now and fight such kind of administration. I thank you very much, but I'm very sympathetic people about what is happening. I think the authorities are going to sit down and find a solution. It's not only about these shacks where we are, the marketplaces. There are other people who have constructed very big empires. They've been brought down by this administration.
So what's your message to
them? My message to the people is,
to
the government, is please find a solution to the people. People now want an immediate solution to their suffering. If you can sit down, then find solution on how people can survive. Because people are surviving about this market. So if you go and destroy them, how are they going to live? Sorry. Very unfortunately, in this kind of situation, I'm not flexible to do that. Thank you very much.
Yes, come back. Glenview A. Sorry, A.